Did you know that insulin resistance can change how you look? And sometimes in ways that can affect your confidence? Most people think of insulin resistance as a hidden problem, something you only discover through blood tests. But in reality, it often shows up in your appearance long before you see changes to your blood sugar levels. So in today's video, we're going to be talking about 5 common ways insulin resistance can change your appearance. But the good news is these changes are reversible. So if you've noticed these signs, don't panic. As you work to improve your insulin sensitivity, these issues can fade and even go away entirely. So let's get into it. The first is dark velvety patches on the skin. One of the most common signs is acanthosis nigricans, which are dark velvety patches of skin that often appear around the neck, in the armpits, and in the groin. And this happens due to high insulin levels. High insulin stimulates the overproduction of skin cells and melanin, leading to thickened, darker skin. This is a strong indicator that your insulin levels are too high. But as I said at the start of this video, a lot of these changes do go away as your insulin levels lower, as your insulin sensitivity improves, and as your insulin resistance reverses. And if you're new to my channel and haven't seen any of my other videos on insulin resistance, the key to reversing it is to keep your insulin low. And you do this mainly by eating a low insulin diet. Sleep, stress, and exercise all do play a role as well. But the food you're eating really has the biggest impact. The second change is what is known as a buffalo hump. This is a fat accumulation on the upper back. This happens because insulin resistance drives fat storage, especially in areas linked to cortisol and stress hormones. Chronically high insulin signals your body to hold onto fat, especially in the upper back and the belly. And while this fat can be stubborn, it's often one of the first areas to improve when you start making changes to your diet and lifestyle and when your insulin levels start coming down. Lower your insulin resistance through a whole food, high protein, low carb diet, mix in some strength training, and this can help to mobilize this fat and reduce the buffalo hump over time. The third change you might see is skin tags. These are small, soft growths that appear around the neck, in the armpits, and other areas with skin folds. Sometimes they even appear on eyelids. This happens because insulin resistance leads to excess growth factors in the skin, causing cells to multiply more than they should. Skin tags are another early indicator of insulin resistance. A lot of people will start getting skin tags, but their blood sugar will look normal. So if you're noticing them, it's time to check in on your metabolic health and get your fasting insulin tested, because insulin resistance starts 10 to 15 years before blood sugar levels start to go up. Basically, what happens is in the early stages of insulin resistance, your cells start resisting the actions of insulin. They start not taking in glucose as they should, and the body produces more insulin to compensate. And this excess insulin is enough to keep your blood sugar in check for years, but eventually it can't keep up anymore. So this is why in the early stages of insulin resistance, your blood sugar looks normal, but your insulin will be high. And that's why it's so important to test your insulin. Now, one myth about skin tags is that they're caused by friction, and this isn't the case. If that were the case, then people wouldn't develop them on their eyelids, which is an area that doesn't experience friction. Now, I've seen this time and time again with clients where they've had skin tags for years and they didn't realize that they were related to insulin resistance. But as we started to bring their insulin down, as insulin resistance starts to reverse, their skin tags actually shrink and sometimes go away entirely. And if that's happened to you, let me know in the comment section down below, because I know that surprises a lot of people. They don't think it's possible, but there is research to back this up, and I've seen it time and time again with clients. The fourth change you might notice is you have hard belly fat. This type of fat is also known as visceral fat. Unlike regular fat that's soft and pinchable, visceral fat is deep inside the abdomen, wrapping around the organs. It creates that hard protruding belly that can be difficult to lose. Think of a beer belly, but it doesn't always have to stick out that far. You can also have visceral fat internally and subcutaneous or normal fat on top. So just because you can pinch your belly fat doesn't mean you don't have visceral fat. It could be hidden underneath. If your belly fat is hard, this is a strong indicator that you're insulin resistant. But again, as you start to lower your insulin levels, your body can begin breaking down this fat for energy. So cut out processed sugar, cut out processed carbs. When you do eat carbs, make sure you're smart about them. I'll link a video on how to do that up above. And as your insulin sensitivity improves, this fat will start to reduce. And the fifth way that insulin resistance can change your appearance is by thinning your hair. High insulin levels increase androgens, or male hormones, which can lead to hair thinning, especially in women. And this is why women with PCOS can experience male pattern baldness, because 90% of PCOS cases are caused by insulin resistance. But again, this hair thinning doesn't have to be permanent. Lower your insulin levels, improve your insulin sensitivity, and your hair will start to grow back thicker. So to recap, if you're seeing dark patches of skin, a buffalo hump, skin tags, hard belly fat, or thinning hair, these could be signs of insulin resistance. But remember that they all can be reversible. And if you're not sure where to start, I'm going to link a video up above that has a meal plan for reversing insulin resistance. This is the framework that I use with clients, and it's super simple. No tracking calories, it's not necessary. And if you do want a little bit more guidance and support, I'm also going to link my insulin resistance masterclass up above as well. With this masterclass, we can work together through a private Facebook group. So if you feel like you need a little bit more support, this is going to be perfect for you. But anyways, guys, let me know in the comment section down below if you have experienced any of these changes and have you been able to reverse them. I love hearing from you guys in the comment section. So even if you just want to come say hi, I appreciate it. And that's all I have. So I will talk to you guys next time. Bye.